Morning students. So class 2, we have, first of all I will give you the answer key for the previous chapter we had completed, how does computer work. So if you have solved your sheets, please tally your answers with this exercise and question answers. And today we are going to start a new chapter, operating a computer. That means how do you operate, how do you start and work on it and switch on the computer or switch off. First of all, we will learn switching on. So these are the steps, students. Number one, turn on the main power supply button, turn on the UPS button, turn on the CPU button, and then fourth is turn on the monitor button and wait for some time. A welcome screen of Windows appears now. Now, Windows is the most popular program that makes the computer work. First is desktop. So this is the desktop. The very first thing that you see when you switch on a computer is the desktop. See? Then icons. These are the icons. The desktop holds many small pictures known as icons. By clicking on these icons, we can open different programs on the computer. Now taskbar. The long bar at the bottom of the desktop is called the taskbar. It displays the name of all the open windows as buttons. Start button. The start button is present on the bottom left corner of the taskbar. Now you see, this is the start button from here and this is the taskbar. Now starting a program. To open the WordPad program, follow the steps given below. First, click on Start, All Program, Accessories and then WordPad. Now how to resize a window. A window is a separate viewing area on a computer display screen in a system that allows multiple viewing areas as part of a graphical user interface. That is, the short form is GUI. You can change the size of a window. Look at the control buttons on the top right corner of the title button. First of all, click on the middle button, restore or down. The WordPad window will become smaller in size. Click again on the middle button to get back to its normal size. Now how to move, deactivate and activate the window. Click on the middle button, the window will become smaller in size. Click and hold the left mouse button on the title bar. Drag the WordPad window to the right side. Now move the pointer over the desktop area and click once. The title bar of the WordPad window turns gray. This means that it is not active, but you can read the items in the Word window. Now, click once on the WordPad working area, the title bar turns blue. It means the WordPad window is active. Now shutting down. How do you shut down? Click on Start button. Click on Shut down option. Wait for some time till the computer turns off automatically. Switch off the monitor button and turn off the UPS button. Now turn off the main power supply button. Switch off the main power supply button directly without shutting down the CPU can harm the computer. So this is very important. Now this is your exercise. So I have solved this exercise for you, and what you have to do, you will write the question answers on your notebook. Now based on that, I will prepare a worksheet for you and that you will solve it yourself. Good day.